Consider this puzzle that people with PhDs got wrong. Imagine you're in a game show. The host asks you to select one of three closed doors. Behind one door is your dream car, and behind the other doors are coats. If you've chosen the right door, you win the prize. You choose door number one, and the host, who knows what's behind the doors, opens door number three, which reveals a goat. He then says to you, "Would you like to switch your door?" Now here's your problem. Is it to your advantage to switch your door? If you think it doesn't make a difference if you switch, unfortunately, you're wrong. This brain teaser is called the Monty Hall problem. It is based on the American TV show Let's Make a Deal, named after its original host, Monty Hall. In 1990, Marylin von Savant, known for holding the record for highest IQ, gave her answer. Her answer attracted a massive amount of feedback. Mathematicians criticized her answer by saying she misled and corrupted the public. Some readers even sent her nasty and sarcastic letters. She then challenged math classes around the country to set up a probability trial. Many responded to this nationwide experiment, and they found out she's right. Now, here's why you should switch. The answer is both simple and strange. Stick around and I will show you an illustration which proves 100% why you should switch to door number 2. Turns out you increase your chance of winning if you switch. To begin with, your chance of winning is 1 in 3. If your door has the car, which only has 1/3 probability, then Monty can either choose door number 2 or 3. But if you choose the wrong door, which has 2/3 probability, then Monty would have to avoid the right door. So switching your door increases your probability of winning. How so? Because there's more chance your initial choice is wrong. Now the question is, are you guaranteed to win every time you switch? No. But if you play this game over and over, on average, you will win 2/3 of the time if you switch. Now you might be thinking, there are 2 doors left, so each door should get 1/2 probability instead. That's a good point, but that's only correct if there were 2 doors to begin with. Remember, there's more chance your first door is wrong, so the host would most likely leave the right door closed. And because there's less chance door number 1 is right, you should switch to door number 2 to increase your chance of winning. Your strategy to win the car should be based on probability. Now here's a grander way of seeing this. Imagine instead there are 100 doors. You choose door number 1. Monty reveals 98 doors, but leaves door number 77. Now it makes sense to switch your door, right? Still here? Great. Now, here's the most interesting part. We will bridge the gap between pure math and real world by using a decision tree. A decision tree is an illustration of different results of a decision. It is commonly used in business management, finance, and even philosophy. Let us pretend Monty allowed you to solve this problem on paper. Let's begin by drawing a box. We will assume the car is in door number 1. Let's start by drawing a line coming out of the box. The number of lines will represent the number of your actions. For this problem, we will list all 6 possible choices, 3 scenarios if you switch, and 3 scenarios if you stick with your door. Each branch will represent each scenario. Now, let's take one branch at a time. Let's assume the car is in door number 1. Luckily, you choose the right door. This is the first branch of your tree. The host will not open door number 1, but he will open door number 2 or 3. This time, he opens door number 3, and you switch to door number 2. You lose. You choose door number 2. The host opens door number 3. You switch to door number 1, and you win. Nice. You choose door number 3. The host opens number 2. You switch to door number 1, and you win again. Great. 2 out of 3 branches lead to winning. So the probability of winning is 2/3, and only 1/3 in losing. Now let's see if you stay with your door number 1. You choose door number 1. The host opens door number 3. And you win. You choose door number 2. The host opens door number 3. And you lose. You choose door number 3. The host opens door number 2. And you lose again. This time, 2 out of 3 branches lead to losing. So the probability of winning is only 1/3. And 2/3 in losing. A decision tree shows you how you should change your view of the future based on new information. It's because new information should influence your decision. You had no reason to be sure the car was behind any particular door. But after Monty opens door number 3, you have more information. This means you need to change your prediction of the outcome. Because as you gather more information, you must change your decision. Like in real life, you collect more information to make the best decision. Hey, thanks for sticking till the end. Likes and subscriptions are appreciated.